showtime.
Court here in the Larry Cole Gymnasium on the campus of Highland Community College in Freeport, Illinois. This is the marvelous one, marvelous Mark Masters, along with the Sultan of Sound, Jim Yeager, and
Arthur, King of the Briton.
And we're here for the championship of the 55th Annual William Bear Classic Tournament, and it will feature your Highland Cougars against number 16 Moberly Greyhounds. The Greyhounds have been a part of this tournament for about 10 years now, and they've been in the championship most of them years. Actually, I only think 1 year they haven't been, if I remember correctly. It might have been last year. Back in 2014 was the first year they were in it. They lost to Marshalltown. They then won four straight. Then they lost to Southeastern Iowa. There was no, obviously, COVID tournament. And then they won it again in 21. Last year was the first year they haven't been in the championship, as they were upset by Sauk Valley in the first round. Almost happened again this season, as they only beat Sauk Valley by two. And here's a rundown of the tournament so far. It's been an interesting one. In the first game, it was Southeastern Iowa 92 over Elgin 57. Moberly again beat Sauk Valley in game two, 67-65. Here's where it got weird. Truman, on the night before the tournament starts, emails Pete Norman telling them they won't be able to make it. So unfortunately, Cougars didn't play last night. So they got a bye to the semifinals. And then Rock Valley won 84-67 in the nightcap game. And then the real late game, Sauk Valley defeated Elgin. Elgin will then finish in seventh place, as Sauk Valley moved on to the consolation championship against Olive Harvey. A couple hours ago, they did win that one 100-90. And in the second round, Moberly took care of business over Southeastern Iowa 63-48, and Highland defeated Rock Valley 71-56. In the third and fourth place game, just finishing up here, Southeastern Iowa took care of Rock Valley easily 77-58. And that leaves one game left to go, your Highland Cougars against the Moberly Greyhounds. Highland comes into the game 8-4, Moberly 10-3 on the day. Some scoring breakdown of last game when Highland beat Rock Valley. 21-11 for Omar Njai. So a great game for him. Look for him possibly to make the all-tournament team. Maybe if the Cougars win, solidify an MVP. We shall see. Also in the MVP voting, I would think, would be D2 Demetrius Johnson. He had 15 points, I believe, 6 rebounds and 6 assists. Also, someone, if he goes off tonight in this ball game, which the Cougars are going to need some people to do so, he could also solidify an MVP. For the visiting Greyhounds, Their players to keep an eye on is number one, Carpenter. He averages 17 points, 4 boards, 3 assists, shoots 79% from the floor, or at least from the free throw line, and 44% beyond the arc. Number two is mainly the distributor. His name is Sykes. He started in 30 seconds of the semifinal game. He had 2 fouls, so he didn't play that much. I don't expect him to get an all-tournament selection, but he's going to be a key guy to keep an eye on. Again, 11 points, 2 rebounds, and 4 assists. He shoots 88% from the free throw line and over 50% beyond the arc. The one man that I think is the favorite is the other man for the Moberly Greyhounds, number 22, Freddie Cooper. When they announced his name for the starting lineup in the semifinal game, I could have swore they said Freddie Krueger, but he was very scary beyond the arc. I don't know exactly how many points he had, but I'm guessing it was over 20. He was all over the place in that semifinal win over the Blackhawks from southeastern Iowa. So keep an eye on him. He's number 22. He averages 11 points and 3 boards a game, but he's had a good tournament so far, so keep an eye on him. He, I think, is a front runner if the Greyhounds win this game here tonight. Got about 4 minutes to go here before we start with the starting lineups. And your Cougars again. He was in uniform last game. I think he is again, but Coach Norman again said he's not going to use him unless it's an emergency. Ramin Hinton, 12 points, 8 boards for him on the season. Il Bosco, I believe he'll be starting tonight. 11 points, 3 boards for him. D2, Demetrius Johnson, I think getting another start. 14 points, 4 boards, 5 assists is his average. Also, don't forget Troy Cole Jr., 12 points and 5 boards, and Omar Ninjai, 10 points and 4 boards. Also, Tyler Johnson with 9 points and 5 boards, and Cyrus Noel, 6 points and 6 boards. So the Cougars, they rebounded well in the semifinals. They're going to need to put it all together here tonight because you can't make too many mistakes against a team like this. The Greyhounds score in bunches, so the Cougars are going to need to keep the defense up, keep the foot on the gas on the offense as well. Again, I mentioned it before, but I'm going to mention it again. A few years ago, a gentleman by the name of Cam Burrell, he came from Morgan Park, Chicago, where he won 2 state championships in high school. He came here, I believe, his sophomore season, and he was for coach, I believe, Tone Boyle. Last season, Tone Boyle was here, and he averaged 9 points and 10 boards. Wound up getting an All-American for the Cougars. And then he went to Western Illinois to play with other former Cougars, Adam Anhold, J.J. Flores, Luca Barasic, and I believe there was another one. I can't think of who it was. But nonetheless, Coach Chad Boudreau, who was the Cougar head coach, or a former Cougar head coach, he also is an assistant at Western Illinois at that time that Cam was there. And then Cam then went on and graduated and now just signed a contract with the world-famous Harlem Globetrotters. So very proud to be a part of the amazing career so far of Cam Burrell, but congratulations to Cam Burrell. Again, a Harlem Globetrotter. He was a former Cougar and All-American here. Speaking of Chad Boudreau, former Highland head coach, he has since assumed the head coaching job at the Leathernecks in Macomb. He's made several trips here during this tournament over years past. Unfortunately, not here this season. We wanted to get him up here and grab a quick few words for him in an interview, but unfortunately, when you're the head man, you're a busy man, and he could not make the trip that I know of this season. So we're about a minute and a half here before we get started on the championship ball game here. But one thing I wanted to ask the coach, Chad Boudreau, is he took John Clancy with him, and if you recognize that name, that is the former Triton Trojan head coach. For 2 seasons, he was 52-13 in Triton, and his first season they went to the Final Four of the national tournament and just got upended by the eventual national champions. I believe that was Northwest Florida State, I think, of some sort. It's down in Florida. Might have been Seminole State. But nonetheless, they had a good season there, so I'm hoping maybe he'll decide to take Patrick Smith, the head coach of the Moberly Greyhounds, next season, make a spot for him. I don't care where it's at on his coaching staff. Just make a spot for him and take him along with him. because the Greyhounds have got a great program, as we've seen over the last 10 years. Again, they've been in this tournament. They've been in the championship just about every season. And there's a reason for it. It's a great program. Cougars usually run into them. That's, I believe, why they invite them and travel to their place and play as well. Because if there comes to be a play-in game like there was last season, we're most likely going to face Moberly. They do a great job coming out of Region 16. And the Cougars, of course, in the Region 4. But once again, we're getting ready to start this ball game here. And the Cougars, for the first time in the tournament, will be in their road blue jerseys, which I always kind of like. And the Greyhounds will be in their home grays. But here we are, Moberly, number 16 in the country at 10-3. Your Highland Cougars unranked at 8-4. Craig, let's go.
Buckle up, weirdos. This one's going to be a good one.
Starting lineup of the Highland Cougars. At one guard, a 6'3 sophomore from Bilbao, Spain. Number 3, El Pasco, Pastor Achia. At another guard, a 6-foot sophomore from St. Paul, Minnesota. Number 4, D2, Demetrius Johnson II. At a third guard, a 6'4 sophomore from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, number 11, Troy Cole Jr. At one forward, a 6'7 freshman from Senegal, number 21, Omar Ninjai. And at a second forward, a 6'8 sophomore from Toronto, Canada, number 23, Air Canada, Cyrus Noel. The Cougars are coached in his fourth season by Mr. Luke Norman.
Regulators, mount up. We're coming.
We're set to roll here. The Cougars will come out in their road blue jerseys with white numbers trimmed in orange. The Greyhounds will come out in their home gray jerseys with red letters and numbers trimmed in black. The PA announcer had the starting lineup a little messed up, but not myself. We're set to roll here again. Championship game. Get Cooper number 22, Carpenter number 1, Sykes number 2. For the Cougars, number 4, D2, Demetrius Johnson, number 3, El Basco Bastrochia, and Jai, number 21, and Troy Cole, Jr., number 11. And Jai looks to jump forward here in center court for the Cougars. He'll be facing Williams, number 33. Jump will go to the Greyhounds. That's Kruger. He'll give off to Sykes. Sykes, the left-handed point guard, leads the show for the Greyhounds. He'll hand off to Cooper. And now Franklin. All three of them can put the ball in the hole. And there's a three on the way. Around and out, rebounded Troy Cole Jr. Ball knocked out of bounds. We'll stay with the Cougars. El Basco will take the ball out for Highland. And he'll give it up to D2, who will take it in the backcourt. Still knotted at zero, just game underway here. Championship by the 55th annual William Bear Classic. Cougars haven't won in 10 years. Could this be the year? D2 around and out. Good look by D2. He couldn't put it down. Now Franklin will bring the ball up for the Greyhounds. Three ball on the way. Got it. That's Robinson. He averages 7-4. He can put the ball in the hole as well. 3-0 Greyhounds to start it off. Some full court pressure. The Cougars break it with ease. And Jai had a solid game this afternoon with 21 points and 11 rebounds. He's got it down low now and see if he's going to face up and bang. He decides to. Nice go to the hole. He missed it. But right there, Air Canada for the board and the bucket. Cyrus Noel with the rebound. And he put it back up, and the Cougars are on the board. Robinson with the ball. Almost stolen. It is stolen. El Bosco will throw down. Two-handed hammer for El Bosco Basterachia. And the Cougars take the lead. Gonzalo had another great game this afternoon. He could be in for a possible all-tournament team bid as well. But the Cougars got to keep the foot on the gas for the offense here, as this is a very explosive ball club. Nice back pass. Back door, Cooper couldn't handle it, and it goes out of bounds. Again, Cooper, number 22, had a great game against Southeastern Iowa. Keep an eye on him. Some more full court pressure. It was deadly against the Blackhawks, but the Cougars break it again. Highland played Moberly already once this year. Had him down to 1 point with a few minutes to go in Moberly. Wound up losing, I believe, by 7. Nice pass, Cyrus Noel, and he's hammered as he was going for a throwdown. Air Canada Cyrus Noel is going to go to the line. He tried to throw one down there, got hammered. Cyrus only had 1 point in the semifinal game, but he had key 6 rebounds. And here he is trying to add to his total. He's got 2, now 3. The Toronto native. Another one of the 8 players returning for Coach Luke Norman. Again, for the most part, in the 11 years I've been here, it's usually 2 to 3. But 8 of them and 7 of them with key playing points or playing minutes in the previous season. It's the second, and the Cougars now with a 3-point lead, 6-3 early on here, championship game. Franklin going to step back for a long 3, no good, but there's an offensive board blocked by Troy Cole Jr. with the swat. Troy can get up in the air and leaps all over people, so watch him. He'll throw down some nasty dunks too. Looking. And Williams finally gets it. Franklin jumper around and out. And there is an offensive foul on the attempted rebound on Williams. That'll be his first. Moberly's going to make some adjustments here. Again, more full court pressure. It was effective against the Blackhawks. Cougars haven't struggled with it yet. Bosco going to bring it up. Nice ball fake over to D2. Wide open, Troy Cole Jr. Got it. Free ball, Troy Cole Jr. And the Cougars extend to a 6-point lead. Again, it's been 10 years since the Cougars have hoisted the first place trophy. They want it this year, and we'll see if they can come up with it. Like I said, keep the foot on the gas. They lead by 6. Here comes Sykes. Tough play, couldn't finish, and he'll go to the line for 2. Again, in the semifinal game, Sykes came out and in the first 30 seconds had 2 fouls and was just like that on the bench for about 10 minutes. Not as solid of a game as he wanted, but towards the second half, he helped the Greyhounds pull away from Southeastern Iowa's first free throw up and in. 9-4 Highland early here, 17:06 left to go, first half. Sykes has got 1 more free throw to go. That foul was on D2, his first. Second free throw up and in for Sykes. D2 to bring the ball up for the Cougars. Greyhounds pull off the pressure. Now are they in a 2-3 zone? It looks like they are. We'll see how the Cougars do against this. They haven't gone too far inside to Njai yet. He was a solid, now it's tipped around, and the Cougars will still come up with it. Watch out, Troy Cole hangs, and he can't put it down, but there's Njai for the rebound. Omar Njai for the board and the bucket. Got the rebound off the miss from Troy Cole Jr. Sykes for the pull-up. It's short. Troy Cole with the board, his second of the game, and here comes Il Bosco. D2 again without Marquand Adams. D2 played 38 of the 40 minutes in the semifinals, and he's the point guard for this ball club. He does a great job, and he's leading the team in scoring. Troy Cole, another three, got it! Troy Cole Jr., another three, and the Cougars out to their biggest lead, 9. Timeout taken by Moberly. 16:09 left to go in this first half. Championship game here. The Cougars lead by 9, 14-5. You want to watch it? The only place you can is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Welcome back. 16:09 left to go in this first half of the championship game of the 55th annual William Bear Classic Tournament. The Cougars with a 14-5 lead here. Again, the Cougars did not play last night. So this is the third game for the Greyhounds. It's only the second one for the Cougars, even though it's the second one today in about 6 hours. So we'll see if the Greyhounds fade with fatigue. Cooper inside. Oh, wow. Tough shot, and he missed it. D2 with the board. The Cougars are going to need to take advantage. Again, foot on the gas and scoring bunches against this Greyhound ball club. D2 will hand off Il Bosco. Looking for the screen, behind the back dribble, and lost that one off the backboard. And look out, here comes Cooper, and he'll lay it up. Cooper had about three dunks in the semifinal win. Again, he's the man to keep an eye on. If the Greyhounds win, most likely we'll pull home the MVP. He's had a great tournament so far. 7-point lead now for the Cougars. Il Bosco on the right side, going to dribble around Cooper. And he's going to step on the line. Just in time for Troy Cole Jr. to drain a three, but unfortunately it doesn't count. T.Y. Tyler Johnson will check in for Il Bosco as he sits down. 2 points for Gonzalo. 15:14 left to go first half. Still a 7-point lead for the Cougars. Franklin now back up top. Number 12, that's May. Tough shot, no good. There's a rebound by Air Canada, Cyrus Noel. D2 going to bring the ball up. Cougars got to take advantage of the cold start here by the Greyhounds. Troy Cole Jr. now looking inside, and Jai's there. Cole's going to go. And couldn't finish. Troy Cole Jr., 2 threes already. Now he's going to go to the line for a couple singles. 14:45 left to go first half, 14-7 Highland. Again, the first and only time the Cougars will wear their road jerseys at home. Of course, unless they go to the Region 4 tournament, which I believe is held here again, as a lower seed, which is always possible. First free throw up and in, Troy Cole Jr. Troy Cole, 14-7 in the semifinal game. Good game for him. He's got one more free throw coming. 76% for Troy Cole. He'll set, shoot, and miss that one a little bit. Cougars almost had the offensive board by Njai. Leading by 8. Reynolds at the top of the key for the Greyhounds. Gets it over to Franklin. Franklin quiet so far. Or excuse me, that's not Franklin, that's Carpenter. Jumper no good. A rebound by Tyler Johnson. Cougars with an 8-point lead in the ball. They went inside to Njai a lot. Let's see if they do it here now. They isolate him down low. Now he's double teamed. And they're going to pick up the foul. Been a long time since the Cougars have had a force inside like Njai. And they exploited the matchup this afternoon. Good, again, for 21 points and 11 boards. Cougars will take the ball out underneath their own basket here on the left side. Still waiting for that Troy Parker alley-oop dunk, which he did in this tournament back in 1995. Now the ball taken away by the Greyhounds. They get it up, and Cooper will score easily. Cooper's going to score in bunches. We got to find a way to contain him.
He's cut the lead down to 6, 15-9, 13:58 to go in the first half. D2. Going to kick it over, Troy Cole Jr. And Jai like it inside. They're not going to get it to him. Back up top to D2. He can dribble. Another one, Troy Cole. Rounding out. Tipped by Tyler Johnson. Another offensive board. The Cougars were all over the boards offensively and defensively this afternoon, and they needed that. They're going to need another big showing on the boards tonight here, and Tyler Johnson got his offensive board, got fouled on the rebound and throwback, so he'll go to the line for two. First free throw, no good. Moy will pick up his second foul and get checked out. El Bosco will come in for Cyrus Noel. 6-point lead for the Cougars. Tyler Johnson, 70%. Averages 9-5 on the season. Second free throw up and in. Cougars struggled in the first half with their free throws, but came on towards the end of the half and in the second half. They lead by 7 right here against the Moberly Greyhounds. Rated 16th in the nation. Carpenter for a 3. No good. El Bosco picks up his first board, and here come the Cougars. D2 going to set up the offense, figure out what they're going to do. Looking for a screen over Troy Cole Jr., trying to get it, and are they going to get a hold here on number 13, Anderson? I believe so. Or no, they're going to call it on Njai. That's his first foul. 13:08 to go, first half. Highland leads by 7, 16-9. Again, Sykes, a left-handed point guard here for the Greyhounds. He can score. Now over to Cooper. Man to keep an eye on. He can score from anywhere. They're going to call El Bosco for the body. That'll be his first foul. Cooper. Looking to give it to Sykes. He'll give it to Robinson instead. Gonna drive to the hoop. Trying to spin. Tough play. El Bosco will pick up another foul. Gonzalo had a great game this afternoon as well. 9 points, 8 boards in 34 minutes, including several threes. He's going to have a seat here as Mo Bucket's set to check in for the Cougars. Cooper, first free throw up and in. Monum Aboud will check in for the Cougars. Well, 45 to go in the ballgame. 6-point lead for the Cougars. Excuse me, first half. Free throw missed by Cooper. Cougars have only trailed once from 3-0. And then they went on a scoring spree. I believe it was a 9-point score. They led 9-3 and haven't trailed since. D2, tough play. Inside and Jai! He tries to throw down. No call. And he missed the dunk. And there, another unforced error by the Greyhounds. Again, how often is too many games in so many days? This is the third game for the Greyhounds, only the Cougars' second, even though it is their second game today. Boris Parachica will check in for the Cougars, and Jai has a seat. Troy Cole going to take the ball out for the Cougars. He's going to look to D2. He's going to work on with Sites. Just a little man token pressure. D2 can handle that with ease. Mona Mabood, a 3-point dagger specialist. Don't let him get open. Up top, T.Y., now over D2 on the right side. Back up top, Parachica, looking for a cutter, no. Now he gets it to Troy Cole. He can hang, tough shot, no good. And the rebound by the Greyhounds. Just under 12 minutes to go in the half. Highland still by 6, they've led the majority of the way. Reynolds will launch a 3. They can't draw anything. It is ice cold for the Greyhounds, and the Cougars need to take advantage of this. It's been a few minutes since the Cougars have scored. They need to put buckets in here as quickly as they can, because when the Greyhounds go on a run, they can score a lot. Up to T.Y., Tyler Johnson. He'll take it across the timeline. And Cougars lead 16-10. D2 will now take it up at the top of the key here off to the left side. The ball stolen by Cooper. Cooper can throw down, and he will. It's now 7 points now for Cooper, and the lead cut to 4. Cougars passing, getting a little sloppy here, and Cooper with the easy steal and dunk on the opposite end. Tyler Johnson here now. Here comes some full court zone pressure by the Greyhounds. Cougars had no problem earlier breaking it, and they do it again. Tyler Johnson up top, D2. 11-15 left to go first half, Highland by 4. TY on the right side. Looking inside for Parachica. Reach around and knock the ball away for the Greyhounds. Cougars got to take care of the ball better. They tried to go inside. It didn't work. Cooper for another 3. Looks short. Somebody's got to get the board. Abood does. There's Tyler. Back up top, D2. Nice pump fake goes right around Cooper to Boris. Nice move. No call. And one. Boris Parachica gets the bucket, draws the foul, and he's going to the line for the and one free throw. And I'll be honest with you, head coach Pat Smith, a little quiet so far. I've mentioned several times to the Salt and the Sound how on earth that man still has a voice for any other game, as he is a screamer. That foul on Robinson, his first. Boris Parachica from Montenegro has a chance for a free throw. Averages 2 points and 3 boards a game. Started this afternoon, coming off the bench here tonight. Could not come up with the and-one free throw. Sykes will bring the ball up. Cougars still lead by 6. Backdoor cut by Cooper. Robinson will pick up the foul and score the bucket. Tyler Johnson picks up the foul, his first. Cyrus Noel will check in for him. 10:25 left to go, first half. Cougars lead by 4. And an and-one free throw coming from Robinson. Robinson, 75% from the stripe. Averages 7-4 a game, and he hits that one. 6 points now for Robinson. More full court pressure. Cougars having no problems breaking it. Troy Cole Jr. on the right side. Just over 10 minutes to go here. D2. D2 hasn't taken it to the hole yet. He can do so usually fairly well. He's got Cooper on him. Not a good pass by Parachica, but a wise foul as Boris stopped the fast break with the foul. Sykes was breaking into the open. An easy layup was coming this direction. And Njai will check back in for Parachica. 10:04 left to go in the half. Cougars lead by 3, 18-5. They've taken the lead ever since, I believe, 4-3 early on, and they haven't relinquished it yet. Three ball on the way for Sykes, no good. Abood will pick it up, and here comes D2. Cougars could use another bucket here, just under 10 minutes left in the half. D2. Going to kick it all the way over, Troy Cole Jr. And the ball knocked away. Greyhound defense starting to stiffen up here. In the corner is Robinson, now up top to Sykes, and he almost lost the ball. Behind the back dribble, nice pump fake, had the shot. He'll go back to Robinson for 3, and he got it. Second 3-ball for Robinson. That's 9 points now. The timeout taken by Highland. 9:25 left to go in the half. The Greyhounds have come storming back. And they've tied it up at 18. Want to continue to watch the championship game? The only place you can watch it is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Back, everyone. 9:25 to go in the half. We're tied at 18. on the three ball by Robinson. Again, this is the championship game of the 55th annual William Bear Classic Tournament. And in the last 10 years, Moberly's won about seven of them, excluding seven of nine, excluding the COVID season, which obviously didn't happen. Or full court pressure. Again, the Cougars have not had any problems with this yet. D2 will cross the line here on the left side. The Greyhounds have survived the knockout punch early on by the Cougars, and now their defense is stiffening. More turnovers by the Cougars. They can't afford that. An ugly-looking shot by Sykes, but it goes in. And the biggest lead of the game now for the Greyhounds, 2 points. They lead 20-18. D2 will take the ball. Cougar offense has now got to come alive as the Greyhound offense has woken up. Jumper, no good, but there's Njai for the board. At it again, needs to go up strong. Still no call down low. Comes Carpenter, he's back in for the Greyhounds. Robinson for another three, this one way short. And Njai will come up with the board and a foul on Robinson. Fourth rebound for Njai, Robinson will pick up foul number two. Oster Achia will check back in along with Tyler Johnson. Troy Cole Jr. has a seat along with Bo Buckets. Already in the bonus here, 8:21 to go in the half. Omar Njai set for a free throw and another. Very solid performance this afternoon. Free throw shooting for Omar. Pretty impressive for a big man. His first free throw up and in. Chance to tie it back up here. Again, the Cougars played Moberly already earlier this season at a Moberly tournament. They fell, I believe, by seven, but had it down to one with a few minutes to go in the ball game. The streaky scoring Greyhounds, as I've said before, went on a run and put the Cougars away. They trail by one at the moment with 8:15 left to go in the half. Williams take it high post, looking for a cutter. He'll get it back to Sykes. Sykes not afraid to take a long three, and here comes one. Around and out, Air Canada, Cyrus Noel with another rebound. And that was the Cougars' biggest Achilles heel in the last few games. They just struggled with defensive boards. The opposing team would just run off offensive board after offensive board. They've done it well. Three ball, got it! D2 for three, and the Cougars back to the lead. First bucket for D2. He's a guy to keep an eye on for the Cougars. He had a decent game in the semifinals as well. 5-6-5, or 14-5-6. Carpenter a three, push off by Williams, no call. He'll get the offensive board and score. Another tie ball game at 22 apiece here, 7:18 left to go first half. In the Greyhounds, number 16 in the nation, 10-3 on the season, the Cougars unranked, and 8-4. One of the four losses came to the Greyhounds not that long ago, tough play, but there's an offensive board, and the score, Omar Njai, 5 boards already and 5 points for the big man. Sykes gonna get the ball stolen by T.Y., Cougars need to push it, and here they come. E2 on the left side in that blind spot for me, and he'll relax, reset up the offense. Cougars up by two here, led by as many as nine. Tough play, and there's Njai for another board. Omar Njai, another offensive board and bucket, and a timeout taken by the Greyhounds. 6:36 left to go in this first half. The Cougar lead back to four. They lead 26-22. You want to watch the end of this ball game? The only place you can watch your Highland Cougar sports streaming live worldwide is right here on HMC. Stick with us. .36 left to go in this first half. Cougars broke out to a 9-point lead here against the Greyhounds. It's dwindled down to four. Greyhounds took the lead here. Their biggest margin was 2 points, I believe. The Cougars came back and tied it up and take now a four-point lead. The Greyhounds face some full-court pressure by the Cougars. They break it fairly easily. Reynolds, I believe, three-pointer, and he got it. The sub players stepping up big for the Greyhounds as the big guns are slow to get the offensive go. Cougars will break the full-court pressure. Their lead is down to one. Inside and Jai. Wide open, Il Bosco. He's going to bang. They decide not to double, and he's fouled as he goes up for the jumper. That's going to be foul number two on Williams. We'll see how long Coach Pat Smith sticks with him. 6:04. That's his third, it says. I must have missed one. And you better believe Williams is going to have a seat here. And Jai goes back to the line for two free throws. 7 points on the evening so far for Omar. Chance to add to it. 6:04 left to go first half. First free throw around and out off the right iron. Anderson will check in. Williams is going to have a seat for a while as he's got two fouls left before he's done. There's still 26 minutes left in the ballgame. Omar Njai, good free throw shooter. Missed the first one, and he'll miss them both. Rare double miss for Njai, but the Cougars still holding on to that one-point lead. Tough play to the hole, and Moy will score the bucket. Just like that, the Greyhounds back to the lead, and Il Bosco will bring up the ball. Splits the defenders, and he dishes to Cyrus. A little behind him, back to D2 for three, got it! D2, another three, and the Cougars back to the lead. 5:30 to go in this half. Carpenter will hand off to Cooper. Reynolds looking inside. He got it inside Anderson, back up top, very close to the end line. Tough play, layup easily there for Moye. Tie ball game at 29 here with 5 minutes to go in the half. Greyhounds struggled out of the gate. Cougars struggled here as of late, all the way over in the corner. Cyrus, nice play, ball fake. Out it went for the shot, would have got the foul most likely, but a three ball by D2, no good. D2 had a good look from the other direction. 4:44 to go in this first half. Carpenter still yet to score, and he still can't. Nice job by Cyrus to take the ball away from Cooper. Cougars going to slow it up here again. Tied at 29. Cougars led by 9 here in the first half. It's dwindled down to nothing. And Jai going to take it to the hole. They're going to call what? They're going to call a foul. Anderson will pick up the foul, his first. And Jai is going to go back to the line here. Is it one or two here? There's quite a few. I believe it's one in the bonus. Troy Cole Jr. will check in for Tyler Johnson. Omar Njai, 7 points for him. He's going to shoot his fifth free throw on the evening. Rarely, though, he's only got one make. Cougars need this one right here. Take the lead back with 4:19 to go. It is up and in. One more free throw for Omar Njai. Cougars back to the lead, 30-29. Again, they haven't won this tournament in 10 years since Luke Norman, I believe himself, won it as a player back in 2013. Second free throw up and in by Njai. 9 points now for him, and a two-point lead for the Cougars with 4:16 left to go in this first half. All the way to the rack, no good. Rebounded by the Cougars, Troy Cole Jr. That miss was by Moye. D2 going to take the ball here, just under now 4 minutes to go. Cougars with a two-point lead. Nice move, pull up. Inside, and Jai, and he got fouled. He'll go back to the line, and Jai's making a putting on a clinic here, getting to the free throw line as he's going to shoot free throw now. 6 and 7 on the evening. Second foul on Reynolds. And Jai back to the line for two. First one, no good. Sykes will check back in for the Greyhounds. Cooper will have a seat. Cooper pretty quiet. No, not necessarily. Cooper with 7 points. But again, he's the guy that if the Cougars let get out of hand here, he could walk away with an MVP tonight. He had a great semifinal game. Omar Njai will hit the second one. 4 for 7 on the evening so far for Njai. Cougars lead now is 3. Sykes kicks it over. Robinson might have lost a handle. Now he's worked on and out of bounds. And nobody knows where it's going. They're going to say it's staying with the Greyhounds. Marquand Adams not in uniform, but still making his presence known down on the bench. Sykes will take the ball out right underneath us here in the universally famous Jim Yeager balcony. He'll get it to Reynolds. Reynolds will back up, worked on by El Bosco. 3:33 left to go in the half. The Cougars by 3. Shot clock down to 5. Reynolds, tough shot, way short. And the ball tipped, and Cyrus will come up with it. Now the Cougars got a 2-on-1 break. Over to El Bosco, got it! Foster Achia with another bucket and a 5-point lead for the Cougars with 3:10 to go. Timeout taken by Moberly. 3:10 left to go in this first half. The Cougars with a 5-point lead. They lead 34-29. Want to watch the rest of it? Stay with us here on HMC. Welcome back, everyone. 55th annual William Bear Classic Tournament championship ball game. The Cougars have not won since head coach Luke Norman was playing under the Nathan Courtney regime back in 2013. They're in control at the moment by 5, 34-29 against the Moberly Greyhounds. Sykes will bring the ball up here, worked on by D2. He's going to dribble off to the left side looking for a screen. He'll take it himself, running one-hander, no good. Troy Cole Jr., rebound number 4. D2, Cougars don't have to rush here. Take some time off the clock and get a good shot. D2 has found a way to get it there. Nice inside, and Jai, and it's taken away. Boy, he will take the ball away, he'll kick it to Sykes. Sykes, tough play, a good no call. And Jai will come up with the 7th rebound of the ball game. Coach Norman wants him to slow up, and they will. Greyhounds do a great job in transition in scoring points. A pass down to Njai, tipped and not taken away now by Carpenter. Carpenter still yet to score. He averages 17 points for the Greyhounds. He's not in the scoring books yet. He has the ball and looking to take a move. Thought he'd take Cyrus off the dribble. 3-ball again by backup Reynolds. That's 2 threes for him. Reynolds only scores 6 points a game, and he's got that already. Under 2 minutes to go, and the Cougar lead down to 2. 34-32. I said keep the foot on the gas here for the offense. Cougars are slowing it down a little bit. D2, pull up jumper, got it. Timeout taken by Highland, 1:41 left to go in this half. The Cougar lead back to 4. They lead 36-32. Want to continue watching this? It's streaming live worldwide only here on HMC. Welcome back. Cougars led by as many as 9 here in this championship game. They lead by 4 at the moment with 1:41 left to go in the half. The possibility of the 3 games in 2 days may be wearing on the Greyhounds as they've been ice cold from outside. Again, their main guns, Cooper, Carpenter, and Sykes, held pretty much in check by the Cougar defense. Ball now, nice job, Njai on the floor! And they're going to call, is it a timeout? Yes, nice job, Omar Njai got the steal, called the timeout. And the Cougars want a 20. Good defense by Omar Njai. Timeout again by the Cougars, 1:29 left to go in this half. They lead by 4, still 36-32. We'll be back in a minute. Stick with us here on HMC. Welcome back, 36-32 Highland with the ball. Off the steal by Omar Njai, some full court pressure again by the Greyhounds. Cougars have not had too many issues with the full court pressure, but it's been deadly in this tournament. Southeastern Iowa had some issues with it. El Bosco to bring it up. Gets it to Troy Cole Jr., so no problems. El Bosco, now the Cougars could push, they don't. The shot clock runs out. There'll be 1 minute left to go in the half. Njai at the top of the key over D2. Nice pass. El Bosco for 3. No good. And we got a sticker. El Bosco sticks it in there. And that, I believe, is a possession arrow. And it will stay with the Cougars. So the jump ball off the sticky. And the Cougars will maintain possession on the jump ball possession. That's how it works. Crowd not liking it for some reason, but we had it earlier in one of the games. It might have been again with Moberly in the semifinals. Pat Smith still working on the officials. He's trying to buy a call here, and it wouldn't surprise me if he gets one. D2 will take the ball out for the Cougars. 20 seconds on the shot clock. 1:04 left to go in the half. Njai now. Double team El Bosco, ball stolen now by the Greyhounds. Pass over to Reynolds. Reynolds kicking out Troy Cole Jr. in the passing lane, and he carries it out of bounds, but he stops the break. Nice job, Troy Cole, to get that steal. Unfortunately, lost the ball out of bounds. So now Carpenter will take the ball out. He'll throw it into Cooper. Cooper will draw the foul on D2. It was lowering the shoulder, but he picks up the foul. That'll be on D2, his second. Under a minute to go. Cooper to the line. Cooper, I believe, no, he's not leading the way, but he's got 7 points so far for the Greyhounds. He'll hit the first free throw. Robinson leading the way for the Greyhounds with 9 points. Cooper can tie that with a free throw here. He can't. Cyrus Noel will sky for a rebound. And the Cougar lead is still 3. 50 seconds left to go. The Greyhounds will get one more shot. D2 going to take some time off the clock here. Osterichia back D2. Left wide open for 3. Looks short, and it is. Cooper will come down with a board. The Cougars will still get another shot as the shot clock is about a 2-second difference from the game clock. Robinson to Carpenter. Carpenter still held scoreless, averaging 17 points a game. Looking to drive. We'll kick it out. Oye, tough off the glass, but nobody there. And Cooper was, but he missed it. Cougars trying to come up with it, a trip and a fall, and he stepped on the line. 10 seconds to go in the half. The Cougars lead by 3, and they now have the ball off the Moberly turnover. El Bosco wants the ball to get it in quickly. Greyhounds set it up. Now to D2. D2 can push it. He does. He deeds it off, and a throwdown! A two-handed facial by Omar Ninjai to end this half here. 3 ball's good if it goes, and woo-hoo, Carpenter just missed it. But an exciting facial throwdown by Omar Ninjai, and that'll end the first half for the Cougars. They lead by 5, 38-33. And a good first half for the Cougars in this 55th annual tournament. We'll be back in about 15 minutes for the second half. Stick with us, everybody. Welcome back here. Halftime of your 55th annual William & Bear Classic Tournament. Cougars with the lead against the number 16 team in the nation, 38-33. Scoring at the moment, Il Bosco with 4 points. D2, Demetrius Johnson II with 8. Tyler Johnson with 1. Troy Cole Jr. with 7. Morris Parachizzo with 2. Omar Nanjai with 12. And Cyrus Noel with 4. People to keep an eye on, D2 with 8. He had a good game this afternoon. Omar Nanjai, 12 points. He had 21 and 11 this afternoon. Again, if the Cougars win, I like Omar Nanjai for the MVP, unless someone else goes off for the Cougars, and that could be D2. He can have some big second halves from beyond the arc. On the other side, Sykes has only got 4. Carpenter with 0. And Cooper, I believe, just behind, he's got 8 points, leading the way for the Greyhounds, Robinson with 9. And that's it. Pretty well spread out, but the main guns for the Greyhounds not doing the work. And unless they show up here in the second half, the Cougars could easily get away with a win here. They lead by 5, led by as many as 9. The Greyhounds have only led on two or three different occasions, and each, the largest lead was 2 points. We're 20 minutes away here from the championship, and the all-tournament team will have that here live. I don't know if Pete Norman will announce it or the PA announcer will, but we'll have that live here on HMC. So stick with us here. And the players, I believe, that are in good running for it for the Cougars are D2 and Nanjai, win or lose. I believe that Cooper was also in the running for, at least for the Greyhounds. He's had a quiet game in the first half here, but you never know, he could go off in the second. It appears the Greyhounds will control the ball here to start this second half. We'll start with Carpenter. We'll take the ball out at half court. Starters back in for the Cougars. Sykes gonna work to the right side. He'll get it to Carpenter. Inside, Cooper, tough shot. He draws the foul. That's on Il Bosco. That'll be his third. And it is not, it is on Nanjai, only his second. Cooper, though, going to the line for 2. Cooper averages 11-3 and 72%, and he hit the first one. The only one in real foul trouble is Williams for the Greyhounds. He's got 3 fouls. Second free throw by Cooper up and in. 10 points now for him, and full court pressure. A little more aggressive now, and Bosco can bring it up. D2 will get it across the timeline. Here comes a trap. Troy Cole inside to Cyrus, back to D2. Looking for a 3, no. Troy Cole for another one, got it! Troy Cole Jr. for another 3, that's 10 points for him. His third 3-pointer of the game, and the Cougar lead now extends to 6. Troy Cole Jr. shoots 25% as far as the stats go, what they have on the NJCAA. But he's hit 3 big ones tonight. 3 ball from Williams, no good. Rebound by D2. I think that is Williams or Robinson, I'm not sure. I don't know why Williams would shoot it, but maybe he does. Will have it, give it to Il Bosco. No, he'll step back himself. Now he's got a mismatch on Williams. He can dribble right around him. He'll pull up for 3, no good. Rebound by the Greyhounds. Cougars still lead by 6, 19 minutes to go in the ball game. Carpenter got away with a walk on a pivot there, inside to Williams. Tough hook shot, no good. Nanjai stood straight up and got his 8th rebound. Omar Nanjai making a strong case for the MVP tonight. The Cougars just got a win. D2. Lost his dribble, we'll get it to Troy Cole. He'll go all the way in, nice inside pass! And a block by the Greyhounds. A fresh 20 though, is Troy Cole Jr. Got it in, 1, no! Count the bucket for Troy Cole Jr. He's having himself one heck of a ball game, and he's going back to the line for the and one free throw. First foul on Carpenter on the evening. 12 points for Troy Cole Jr. Here he has a chance to add one more. They give the Cougars back their biggest lead of the ball game. It'll be back to 9 points. It's 8 at the moment at 43-35. And he got it. 13 points now for Troy Cole Jr. 44-35 Highland. Still a lot of time left in the championship ball game. Sykes will get it to Williams. Looking for a cutter inside. We'll hand off to Sykes. Sykes will step back. No, now he's going to pull up for a 15-footer. Around and out. Troy Cole Jr. with the board. Fifth rebound for Troy Cole. 18-10 to go in the ball game. 44-35 Highland. Bosco going to take it to the hole, all the way to the rack. Reverse layup, no good, but right to Cyrus. Cyrus Noel for a punctuation mark. A big two-handed hammer, and the Cougars lead now by 11. Timeout taken by Moberly. Could this be the year? The Cougar fans are coming alive here, and they lead by 11. 17:49 left to go in the ball game. We'll be back here in a minute. Stick with us here on HMC. Welcome back. A thunderous two-handed hammer by Cyrus Noel have given the Cougars their largest lead of the ballgame, 11 points, 46-35 here. I've said all along, the Cougars are tough to beat on their home court. They had it close against Moberly in Missouri, but fell in the end. Right now it's looking good here on their home court. We'll see how long it lasts. Sykes gonna work on Air Canada now. He'll hand off. Now Carpenter. Tough shot and no good. A rough shooting night for the Greyhounds, and the Cougars are taking advantage. They lead by 11 here with the ball. Troy Cole on the left side. He's had an impressive game. Il Bosco now up top to Troy Cole. Ball tipped by Cooper and stolen. Tough shot. He missed it. Troy Cole had the board. Seventh rebound for Troy Cole Jr., an easy layup missed by Cooper. And again, you wonder if the 3 games in 2 days is having some effect on the Greyhounds. Cooper usually just dunks that, but with Troy Cole in his grill, he went for the layup and missed it. Il Bosco all the way up top, Troy Cole. Shot clock under 10. D2 inside, Njai, nice pump fake. Kicks it back out, D2 with one. Let's it fly, no good, but there's Cyrus for the board. D2 goes down. D2 is still down. Cougars got to get back here, and they're going to call a timeout. D2 went down hard. He's holding his calf, and that's one thing the Cougars can't lose. They've already lost their one point guard in Marquand Adams, and D2 is down. 16:32 left to go in the ballgame. The Cougars up by 11. And a timeout for an injured player for the Cougars. It's Demetrius Johnson II. And D2 with 8 points, 2 rebounds. He's usually the leader on the floor at the point. Really can't afford to lose him. Il Bosco does a fine job as well. But it's hard to argue D2's ability at the point. Hopefully he's not out for long in either the game or the season for the Cougars. He hit hard and was in a lot of pain. I'm not a doctor, so I have no idea if it's a cramp. Okay. Landed on the player's foot, maybe a rolled ankle. appears to be favoring the ankle, so we'll see. I would say his return is very questionable. We shall see. Still a lot of time left, but now the Cougars are going to have to move on without him. I'm not sure who's in for him. I believe it's probably T.Y., but we shall see. Cougars and the injury bug have been biting him quite a bit here. Again, Ramin Hinton in uniform, but most likely not unless it's an emergency situation. Will he see the floor tonight? Marquand Adams also rolled an ankle. He's in street clothes. Matt Somerville still nursing an injured hand. And Jaheen Siago still with a bad broken foot. So the Cougars by no means at 100% here. It is T.Y. will come in for him. And it looks like the Cougars might go to a 2-3 zone. Sykes will bring the ball up for the Greyhounds. Again, 16-30. Mark that down. D2 goes out. We'll see if that affects the Cougars. Cougars not in a 2-3 zone. They are in man. The ball knocked out of bounds by Buster Achia. Sykes will take the ball out for the Greyhounds underneath their own hoop. And the Cougars lead by 11, biggest lead of the ball game. Hand it to Williams, back to Sykes. Sykes, nice pump fake. Tough shot, no good. Cyrus was there. And fortunately, an easy layup for Williams, but worse off, the third foul, I believe, on Omar Njai. It is. He's leading the way for the Cougars tonight on the scoring column. They really can't afford him to sit down too long. Williams shooting the and-one free throw. And third foul for Njai, and he missed it, but an offensive board. Nice job, Buster Achia, to swat the ball away, and the Cougars will come up with the steal. Just over 16 minutes to go, the Cougars by 9. Il Bosco now going to face a 2-3 zone from the Greyhounds. Inside, Njai. Troy Cole for 3! And they got the foul. He hit nothing but net, but unfortunately it was kind of the front of the net. So he'll go to the line for 3 free throws. Sykes will pick up the foul, his first. But Troy Cole Jr. going to the free throw line should be 4-3. Nine-point lead for the Cougars, just under 16 minutes to go. First free throw for Troy Cole, no good. 76% from the free throw line is Troy Cole. He missed his first one so far. He's got 2 more to go. Chance to give the Cougars a 10-point lead, and he does. 14 points now for Troy Cole Jr. And Jai will have a seat. Boris Parachizo will check in for the Cougars. 1 more free throw. 10-point lead here, Troy Cole Jr. He'll set, shoot, and score. 15 points now, 11-point lead for the Cougars, just under 16 minutes to go in the ballgame. Cooper on the right side, a definite scoring threat, going to try and pull back jumper, T.Y. in his face, might have blocked that, partially rebound by the big man. Cyrus Noel going to take it to himself. How'd he go open? Wide open, Troy Cole for another 3, this time missed. Troy Cole at the offensive board, and they're going to call a jump ball, and it will stay with the Cougars. 8th rebound for Troy Cole Jr. He went back up. The ball got taken away. And the good news is his D2 is over sitting next to assistant head coach Eric Walton for the Cougars. He's still rubbing his thigh, so he probably will get back into this ball game. Right now the Cougars with an 11-point lead and the ball. Throws it up top, and Parachizo took too many steps. That is something I've seen several times during this tournament, and they finally called it on the one guy that plays for the Cougars. And Jai will check in for him here. Omar's got to be careful. He's a scoring threat and a presence inside. If he has to give up a bucket, he's got to do it. Can't necessarily challenge it. Tough play, another good board by Omar. 9 rebounds already for Omar. One more and he's got another double-double. 21 and 11 this afternoon. got 12 and 9. Oscar Chia taking it to the hole. No call. Come on. Here comes Reynolds and the Greyhounds. Still trailing by 11. Under 15 minutes to go in the ball game. Carpenter, maybe. No, blocked by Ninjai. Big block by Omar Ninjai. And the Cougars, again, an 11-point lead here, and they have the ball. Someone's got to flash into the center here. The guards are getting a little far out. Good ball movement. Troy Cole going all the way. We'll kick it out. Three ball. Tyler Johnson got it. Tyler Johnson for three. And now the biggest lead of the Cougar game is now 14 points. And D2 checking back into the lineup for Boster Achia. 51-37 Highland. 14-22 left to go in the ball game. Sykes to bring the ball up, D2 back in. Let's see if Sykes challenges the ankle. Still looks a little gingerly, but we'll see. Maybe he's playing possum. Williams will hand off to Reynolds. Reynolds will launch the three, around and out, tipped, and big man Cyrus Noel comes down with the board. The bigs for the Cougars have been huge on the boards tonight to limit the second chance opportunities for the Greyhounds. D2 gonna take it, tries to kick it out to Johnson. Sykes with the steal. He goes in, and they're going to call a terrible call.
I can't believe you're a professional. I think you should be working at the snack bar.
Missed call there, and the Boo Birds are out on him. Didn't like that all. A great job by Tyler Johnson to stick straight up, and Sykes missed it. Sykes will go to the free throw line. First one looks off to the right, and he missed it. Again, in this tournament, each team will play two games in one day. It just depends on what day it is. The championship teams will play two games on that day, the championship being the second one, and the Greyhounds have played three games now in 2 days. That might be the issue. Who knows? Sykes will hit the second one. Cuts the lead to 13. More full court pressure. Cougars do a good job. Cyrus is open if they need to, but Tyler will get it across the timeline. Get it to Troy Cole. Now gets it Njai. Njai can take Williams off the dribble. Maybe get his fourth call. Nice spin around. Tough shot. Got it and one. And that's number four on Williams. Omar Njai having his way down low and another bucket. Foul and a chance for another free throw for the big man. Number four on Williams, and he's going to sit down for a while. 13:26 left to go in the ball game, and the big man for the Greyhounds is going to have a seat for a long time. Omar Njai, 14 points, 9 rebounds, and has a chance to add to it with the and-one free throw. Free throw is up and off, no good. But the Cougars' lead is now back to 15, a biggest lead of the game, I think. Reynolds lost the handle, stolen by Cyrus. Cyrus wisely gets it to D2. They didn't have numbers for any sort of a break. And right now, they can run a little clock and get a good shot. D2 again, hurt the leg, looked like maybe only a cramp. Or whatever ankle he stepped on, didn't roll quite as bad as he's back in now, almost lost it. And now knocked out of bounds, we'll save it to Cougars. Cooper not having as good of a game as he had this afternoon, struggled with it. Sykes bounced the ball off of Cooper, and Cooper knocked it out of bounds. 12:46 to go in the ball game. The Cougars lead by their biggest lead of the game, 15 points. They lead 53-38. But don't sleep on the Greyhounds. They can score in bunches, and they could be back in this game in a matter of minutes. One thing I said, keep the pedal on the gas, keep scoring points. Cougars can't afford to hold up. And they're going to call the fourth foul on Omar Njai on a moving screen. Oscar Achia set to check in. Omar going to have a seat with four fouls, but he sits down with 14 points. 14 points, 9 boards. That could be the Cougar MVP here. Definitely has earned his spot on the all-tournament team, along with D2. Troy Cole Jr., though, having quite a game himself. He's got 15 points leading the way for the Cougars. Cooper picks up his dribble. Carpenter trying to get it again. Carpenter averages 17 a game, has nothing. Cooper, tough shot, no good, and the Cougars tip it right back out to Carpenter. Another three ball on the way, and that's tough to get rid of. Reynolds with his third three of the ball game. Leads down to 12. With 12 minutes to go, Cougars break the pressure easily. D2 has it. Back into man-to-man are the Greyhounds. Cougars could pull out three players on the all-tournament team with, and they're going to call D2 with a moving screen. Only his third. Coach Norman not happy, and neither are the crowd here. Greyhound starting to get those calls that Patrick Smith was working for. Carpenter looking to drive. We'll hand off to Cooper. He still missed it. Troy Cole Jr., another board. Ninth rebound, Troy Cole gonna go up. Should be a call, of course not. No call, of course not. Coach Norman's gonna come unglued here. Robinson for a wide open three. Still struggling beyond the arc are the Greyhounds. Il Bosco with the board. 11 minutes coming up here in the ball game. The Cougars by 12. Cougars need to take their time, get a good shot. Troy Cole looking down low for Cyrus. He's gonna want a bang. And he's gonna bounce it off his knee and out of bounds. Is that Pete hollering down there? Oh. Oh, we don't know what's going on. And they're going to give it to the Cougars. I don't know how. I could have swore it bounced off of Cyrus's knee. But the Cougars get a payback call here, I guess. Cougars setting up. Here we go. Pass out to D2. Call a foul! Good Lord!
Everybody clap your hands.
Officials starting to struggle here, as I thought they would. 53-41. Second foul on Carpenter. Il Bosco will take the ball out, and they're going to call. It should be a hold on Carpenter, and it is. That's Carpenter's third. Starting to even out the fouls here. Took them a few minutes. Here we go again. D2 will take the ball out right underneath us here in the Jim Yeager balcony. Nope, now it'll be Buster Chia. And the ball kicked by Cooper. We'll stay with the Cougars. 10:43 to go in the ball game. 53-41 Highland. Scoreboard has forgotten to go to the second period. Tyler Johnson now, Cyrus Noel. Gets it to Buster Chia. Shot clock, plenty of time left, down to 14 seconds. D2 with the ball, over to Gonzalo. He's gonna drive, he'll pull back, jumper, got it! Il Bosco for two, that's 6 points for him, and back to a 14-point lead for the Cougars. 10:20 to go in the ball game. Carpenter still scoreless. Three ball on the way, way short by Robinson, and knocked out of bounds. That should be a foul on Cooper, and it will be, but that's only Cooper's first. Or maybe not. It might be 13. It is on 13. Anderson's second. Full court pressure now by the Greyhounds. Troy Cole Jr. checks in for Mo Buckets as he has a seat. Il Bosco will get it. And he'll take it back and get it over to D2. Goes to the center and gets it to Il Bosco. The Cougars break the press. Greyhounds really not having a whole lot of success with that. Del Bosco over now. Troy Cole now up to D2. Under 10 minutes to go in the ballgame. D2, tough play. No call again. And here we go. Greyhounds back the other way. Carpenter still searching for his first bucket and around it out. Another tough one. But unfortunately, bad luck to the Cougars as D2 had the ball. Unfortunately, lost it out of bounds. Again, Carpenter, number one, 17 points a game, has zero. And he'll take the ball out for the Greyhounds. To Cooper, who loses the handle. The Greyhounds just struggling tonight in many facets of the game. Cooper up and a block, but unfortunately it goes right in for Cooper. 12 points now for Cooper. Over back to Il Bosco. E2 can bring it across the timeline now, and he'll get it to Troy Cole Jr. 9:20 to go. Cougars by 12 here, 55-43. Great job defensively for Highland. Troy Cole now up to D2. Cougars working some clock. Pass out. Troy Cole for three. No good, but there's T.Y. had the offensive board but lost it. Under 9 minutes to go in the game. Cougars still up by 12. Cooper. Now that's got to be a charge. No!
This guy sucks.
Boo! You stink!
Terrible call. A great charge by Troy Cole Jr., but he's going to pick up the foul on another blown call. Officials had a great first half, a little shaky second half, as we all knew they could. Cooper going to the line here for a couple free throws. 55-43, Highland still with a 12-point lead. 8:52 to go. Cooper most likely has punched his ticket to the all-tournament team. He's having a solid game now for the Greyhounds. First free throw up and in. 13 points now for Cooper. Again, at the semifinal game when they announced his name, his first name's Freddie. I thought they said Freddy Krueger. I'm like, you got to be kidding me. That's a great name. But it's Cooper. Second free throw. No good. Tyler Johnson with the board. D2 will bring it up. 11-point lead for the Cougars. T.Y. going to dribble to the left. Looking for a cutter. The ball knocked away. Cyrus will corral the steal back. And they're going to... This is terrible! What are you calling? Call it both ways! Terrible call. That'll be Cyrus Noel's first. Offensive fouls galore this tournament. They totally missed one against Troy Cole Jr. on the charge. Three ball by Cooper, short. Air Canada there with the rebound, his seventh, and another loss. And the ball goes up and in. Moy with another bucket, and the lead cut to 9 with 8 minutes to go. Cyrus got away with a push-off on Moy on the jump. Moy will go to the other end and lay it in. Timeout taken by Highland, 55-48, 7:48 left to go in this ball game. We got another dedication for the officials here. Stick with us, everyone.
This guy sucks. This guy.
Boo, you stink!
Boo, you stink!
I can't see anything.
Use your open eye, Frank.
back here. The Cougars again led by as many as 15 here in the second half. It's down to 7. 7:48 left to go. Some horrendous officiating to go along here down the stretch. Omar Njai back in for the Cougars. He's got 4 fouls. Now he's really got to be careful on everything he does because the officials are calling every crazy call you can think of. Troy Cole Jr. going to take the inbounds. And he's going to take it to the hole. Tough shot, and he couldn't finish. Nice job to the rack by Troy Cole Jr. He got the call. That's the 3rd on Anderson, and Troy Cole Jr. going to go to the line. Free throw number 6 and 7 for Troy Cole Jr. He's leading the way for the Cougars with 15 points. His first free throw up and in. Cyrus Noel will check back in as Tyler Johnson has a seat. Lead back to 7 for the Cougars. 7:40 left to go in the ball game. Again, the Cougars haven't won this championship since head coach Luke Norman was a member of the ball club. Second free throw up and in. Now 17 points for Troy Cole Jr. and a 9-point lead for the Cougars. Carpenter will give it to Cooper and back to Carpenter. Carpenter was wide open, trying to get it to him. Robinson back to Moye. Tough play. Surprisingly, they're not going up against Njai. No good. Cooper, tough board. Another tough board. And a tip out. Nice job by El Bosco. Just over 7 minutes to go in the ballgame. The Cougars have a chance to get the lead back to double digits. They lead by 9, 57-48. 7 minutes to go. There we go. Now we're starting to get some of them weak calls that they've been calling earlier. 3rd foul now on Moye. And we should be in 1 and a bonus here for the rest of the game for everybody. 7 minutes, just under 7 minutes to go in the ball game, and we're in free throw shooting time. 8 points for D2. 87% from the line. This is his first 2 free throws of the evening. Had plenty of them in the semifinal game. Sophomore from St. Paul, Minnesota. He's gonna set for the first one and missed it, and I guess it was a 1 in the bonus. Well, that's what I said it was. But he missed the first one. Still a 9-point lead for the Cougars. Sykes has been quiet on the scoring column as well. Nothing as quiet as Carpenter. He's going to take it himself, and he'll throw it up. No good, but he's going to draw the foul. Cyrus Noel will pick up the foul, his 2nd. And Carpenter is going to go to the line again, held scoreless, averaging 17 points a game. The Cougars doing a fine job slowing him down. And he still can't get on the scoreboard. 6:36 left to go in the game, 57-48 Highland. The 3 games had to be having an effect here against the Greyhounds as they are struggling offensively all over. 48 points here with 6 minutes to go in the ball game. Carpenter finally on the board with a free throw and cuts the lead to 8. E2 over to El Bosco. And he'll give it up, Troy Cole Jr. Troy will get it back. El Bosco, 6:20 left to go in the ball game. And Jai gonna dribble, give it to El Bosco. There's definitely a mismatch. If Sykes is gonna go on him, they've switched up. Shot clock down to 5. D2 gonna take it all the way to the rack. And he's hammered. And D2 goes down again. At least the officials are calling fouls now. Before D2 gets hip checked out of the building. That's the 4th foul on number 13, Anderson. I believe he is the man that is taking the place of Williams, who also has 4 fouls for the Greyhounds. D2 will go back to the line. And I believe it is 1 in the bonus yet again. 6:07 to go in the ball game. D2's first free throw up and in. Again, I believe D2 will be a part of the all-tournament team here. Troy Cole Jr. has had a great game. He could sneak in as well. Omar and Njai, I believe, another one. Question is which one of the three will be the MVP? Cougars got to win first, and another free throw by D2. And the lead up to 10 with 6 minutes to go. Sykes, nice ball fake, blocked by Njai. And the Cougars lose it out of bounds, and here comes Williams. He's got four fouls, just under 6 minutes to go. 59-49, Highland. The two big men down low, Njai and Williams, both with four fouls. Again, Omar is still going for blocks. He's got to be careful. The Cougars cannot afford to have him go out just for his size, mainly. Sykes on the left side. He's going to travel to the hole. Tough shot, and he missed the layup. But he'll go to the free throw line. 5:46 left to go in the ball game. D2 picks up foul number four. As much as the Cougars can't afford to lose him, they do have a couple players, or at least one player, Il Bosco, that can handle the rock fairly well, so we don't want D2 to go out either. But we're really shorthanded on size down low if we lose Njai. We got Cyrus down there. Tyler Johnson checks in for D2. 9-point lead for the Cougars. Sykes has got one more free throw to go. It's up and in. Sykes with five free throws and a bucket for 7 points for him. Il Bosco will get it across the timeline. Up top, Troy Cole Jr. will hand it to Il Bosco. And this crowd's going to come under glued here. Another call on Troy Cole Jr. That's his second. That was a great flop. Carpenter, a me turn, and it's still coming up dry. He needs to quit shooting for the Greyhounds. 8-point lead for the Cougars, just over 5 minutes to go. Let's see what terrible call the officials can draw up here. Troy Cole should just take it himself. Now Njai working on Williams. Take it to him. We'll kick it all the way over. Il Bosco on the left side. Three ball on the way, no good. And the ball out of bounds will go to the Greyhounds. Under 5 minutes to go, 8-point lead for the Cougars. Cougars got Air Canada, Bastur Achia, Troy Cole Jr., Njai, and Tyler Johnson in. Three ball, and Sykes finally gets one. Couldn't come at a better time for the Greyhounds at the lead now cut to 5, 59-54. Troy Cole will get it over Cyrus. Gets it out, Bosser Chia. Nice ball fake, he's gonna go. Gives it to Cyrus. These guys are terrible. Another offensive charge. These clowns are nuts. This is embarrassing.
Who the hell is this guy?
A block's a block. It's not hard to call. Like we felt, it can go downhill. Greyhounds benefiting once again. For some brutal calls. 59-54, Highland still with the lead. 4:27 left to go in the ball game. Someone take a charge. Sykes again dribbling the ball. Lost the handle. That's a walk. That is a terrible call and a walk. Sykes with a bucket. These guys are brutal. Up to Cyrus. Lead down to 3, 4 minutes to go. You owe us about 5 calls. And there better be one. We're going to call that foul on Reynolds. That's his third. Double bonus now. D2 will go to the line for the Cougars. .355 left in the ballgame. 3-point lead for the Cougars. They led by as many as 15 this half. But the officials helping out the Greyhounds here. And they've got it down to 3. D2 will go to the free throw line for the double bonus, I believe. D2, again, one of the better free throw shooters for the Cougars. 87%. His first one's up and in. Eleven points for D2. Oster Achia will check back in for the Cougars. Tyler Johnson has a seat. 4-point lead, 3:55 left to go in the ballgame. Second free throw, around and out. Still a 2-possession game for the Cougars, just over or under 4 minutes to go. Moye for a 3, and he got it. First 3 for Moye, and the lead down to 1. D2 will bring the ball up for the Cougars and gets it to Troy Cole. 3:30 to go in the ball game. D2 going to take it. Nice pass down low. Cyrus for the bucket. And a timeout taken by Highland. 3:21 left to go in the ballgame. The Cougar lead is 3. They lead 62-59. What's the best NJCAA stream watchable? It's right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone.
This guy sucks.
Boo, you stink!
This guy sucks. This guy sucks.
Boo, you stink!
I can't see him. Use your open eye, Frank.
I can't believe you're a professional. I think you should be working at the snack bar.
Snack bar is correct. These officials need to find the snack bar. I don't know either, Bob, how they're professionals. 3:21 left to go in the ballgame. 3-point lead for the Cougars, 62-59. We'll see if we can get any calls here this last 3 minutes, because I believe the Greyhounds have used their quota up. Cougars set to come out of this break here. Again, they led by 5 at the break. They lead by 3 now. Led by 15 in this second half at 1 point. I was going to say the Greyhounds should take the ball out down here, which is when the Cougars called timeout. Cougars with 1 timeout left, 2 for the Greyhounds. Sykes will bring the ball up. To take it himself, will get it over to Reynolds for a 3. And now it's starting to warm up. Reynolds is 4th 3 of the ball game, and the game is tied at 62. Greyhounds again down by 15 in this half. They've come back with authority. Like I said, they can score. D2, nice dish, will go to Cyrus for the layup. Cyrus Noel, huge, with a big layup here. We're under 3 minutes, and the Cougars back up by 2. Cougars need a stop. Sykes going to go to the hoop. No good. Over the back. Should have been called on Williams, but a nice board. The 10th rebound for Ninjai. He's got another double-double. And the Cougars just need to finish off the game for the MVP. D2 at the top of the key. 2-3 zone now for the Greyhounds. Troy Cole outside. Shot clock down to 7. Gonzalo with three, and the ball stolen by Sykes. Sykes will lay it up and in for the easy bucket. Back tied again with 2 minutes to go in the ball game. The officials have been brutal down the stretch, helping the Greyhounds get back into this ball game. Inside and Jai, he could take it to the hole. He's got four. Up and strong, he missed it. And the ball almost knocked out of bounds, but the Greyhounds will control. It's been a long time since the Greyhounds have possessed the ball with a chance to take the lead. Sykes with the ball. They have a chance to run the ball or the clock down to about a minute. Sykes trying to get it inside. And a bucket by Williams. The Greyhounds with the lead with 1:18 left to go. Troy Cole Jr. has the ball for the Cougars. Cougars need a good shot. Inside, Cyrus Noel over Troy Cole. He's going to take it in, take it up against him. And there he goes. Williams is gone. Fifth foul on Williams, and he's out of here. Troy Cole Jr. finally wisely took it up against the big man. He got the fifth foul. And he's going to the line with about a minute to go to tie this game back up.
What you say?
Two free throws for Troy Cole Jr. He's got 17 points on the ball game. First one up and in. Eighth free throw of the night coming for Troy Cole Jr. The Cougars trail by one. 1:01 left to go in the ball game. Troy Cole Jr. has a chance to tie the game up. Second free throw, no, rounding out. Under a minute to go. The Cougars will get another shot here. We'll see what the Greyhounds want to do. They're going to run off as much clock as they can. Sykes, travel! Call the travel! Holy cow!
Everybody clap your hands.
Cougars finally get a call here, and they trail by one with the ball. 40 seconds left to go. However, with a bucket, there's still going to be 10 seconds left for the Greyhounds. So a made bucket most likely is going to be a timeout for the Greyhounds as they battled back. They trailed by 15 in this half, and the officials got them back into it with some brutal calls down the stretch. D2 is going to bring the ball up across the timeline. Again, about 10-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Cougars can't afford to be sloppy here. They got to find a good shot. There's Njai, going to take it to the hole. Nice pump fake, up and one! Nomar Njai! Huge bucket gives the Cougars the lead, and he's got a chance to add to it with the and one free throw, and goodbye number 13. Anderson will foul out.
Hit the road.
He's sitting on 16 and 10 right now.
I'll have to pack my things and go.
That's right, hit the road, Jack. And don't you come back no more.
1 point lead for the Cougars. And Jai has a chance to make it two. 21 seconds left to go. The Greyhounds most likely will play for one. Free throw up and in. 17 points, 10 boards, Omar Njai. Timeout taken by the Greyhounds. 21 seconds left to go in the ballgame. The Cougars lead 68-66. You want to watch the end of this ballgame? The only place you can watch it is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Here we go. 21 seconds left to go in the championship game. The Cougars by two, 68-66. Both teams in the double bonus, and the Greyhounds have the possession on a jump ball. Greyhounds most likely going to hold for one here because they, why not? They can win on a three, can tie with a two. Sykes going to go to the hole. Blocked by T.Y., and they're going to screw him over with a body foul. They haven't called that garbage all night. Sykes going to the line, a chance to tie it up, but still a lot of time for the Cougars. We'll be looking for the same call down here. Sykes needs them both, and he's going to be, oh, I thought that one was going to rim out to the right side, but he cradled it in. 1 point game, Cooper back in for the Greyhounds. 14 seconds left to go, Cougars by one. The Boo Birds are out. Let's see if Sykes can tie it up. And it looks like he will. Timeout taken by Moberly. 14 seconds left to go, we're tied at 68. The Cougars got a shot. You couldn't ask for a better opportunity here. They've been blown out of this game the last few years, especially last year by Southeastern Iowa. They're in it right now, a chance to win it for the first time in 10 years. They got 14.9 seconds to come the length of the court and get a shot up and in. Nobody, no, both big men out for the Greyhounds. We'll see if they go inside to Omar and Jai. He's come up huge already tonight. We'll see what Coach Norman's drawing up. 68-68. Only Cougars in foul trouble are D2 and Omar and Jai. The two guys, I think, are going to punch their ticket for an or not necessarily an MVP, but definitely an all-tournament team here at the conclusion of this ballgame. I believe Njai has the MVP wrapped up with a Cougar win. I have no idea who will get it if the Greyhounds pull it off. Sykes has finally come out of nowhere. He only had about 3 or 4 points at the end of the first half. It wasn't a shocker that he was going to take it to the hole. He hit the two free throws. And now the Cougars have the line, the baseline to run if need be. Now full court man-to-man pressure. D2 has it. Again, the Cougars don't have to score here, although it'd be nice if they did. A bucket, any point wins. We're down to six. We're down to five. It's D2's chance. We're down to three for the win. No good. And the ball go out of bounds, and we got overtime. I don't know if the Cougars had a different play drawn up, but it was D2's chance to shoot for the win. I wish he would have taken it to the hole, drew some sort of a foul. But we're now in overtime of the championship game. 5 minute overtime. The last time the Cougars were in a championship game and it went to overtime was the Region 4 championship last year against Triton. They came out victorious. And they have a chance to do it against a really good ball club here tonight. 5 minutes to go. 68-68. We'll be back in a minute. Stick with us here. Cougars said finish as they came out of the break. 5 minutes to go in the ballgame. Again, the two big men for the Greyhounds out with fouls. Two of the most important Cougars on the floor with four fouls are D2 and Omar Njai. And here we go. We're going to do this again.
Regulators, mount up. We're coming.
And Jai set the jump at half court once again. This time he'll go against Robinson. Five-minute overtime. 68-68. Cougars led by 15. And the ball will go up. And the Cougars will maintain. D2, Troy Cole Jr. We'll get it back up, Bosser Achia. Gonzalo gonna take it to the hole, the ball hit his hand, and they lose it. Here come the Greyhounds. Sykes. Oh, they're going to call Gonzalo for the foul. Only his third. Oh, they call it his fourth. I must have missed one. So now Il Bosco with four. Sykes going back to the line. First free throw by Sykes around and in. Tyler Johnson will check in for Bosser Achia. Got Cyrus Noel, Troy Cole Jr., D2, Omar Njai, and Tyler Johnson in as Sykes got one more free throw to go, and he'll hit it. Greyhounds by two. Cougars got a few players in foul trouble now. The two big men for the Greyhounds are out, so the Cougars, I would think, would want to go inside, see what they can do. D2. Looking inside for Njai, and they throw it away. And a ball stolen. Good job. Dumb play by the Greyhounds, and Tyler Johnson is there to get the steal. They still trail by two, just under 4 minutes to go in the game. We're in overtime, so free basketball. Call something, Jesus! Three ball, nail that! Made up for it there. Three free throws coming for Tyler Johnson. Is that Cooper's first? And down goes D2 again. He's been putting through a lot of brutal attacks here tonight. But he's a warrior. He's been working through it. And he'll do it some more.
This guy sucks.
Boo, you stink!
Once again, another dedication to the officiating tonight. 3:31 to go in overtime. The Greyhounds have the 2-point lead. Cougars will be shooting some free throws after D2, who is still down. Make it off the court. He's been down two or three times. He's muscled through it all together, and he's back up again. Mo Buckets, Mona Mabood will check in for D2. Injury bug has bitten the Cougars badly so far this tournament. Ken Ramin Hinton in uniform, but they don't want to use him unless they run out of guards. They still have a few left. But D2 walking off again. I'm not sure if it's a cramp or an ankle. Tyler Johnson set for two. He's got 4 points tonight. 1-3 and a free throw. He's got, I believe, three coming here, and he missed the first one. Second free throw, short. Cougars now struggling from the free throw line. One more free throw for Tyler Johnson. He missed all three of them. 2-point lead for the Greyhounds. Sykes turnaround jumper, no good. Robinson with the offensive board, another tough play, and they're going to say Cougar ball. That call might not have supposed to go the Cougars' way, but for once we'll take one because we deserve one. 2, 3, 4, 5 now calls. Cougars got the ball, 3:11 here, trailing by two. Be awake for number 10. Mo Buckets can drain the threes like he's not even moving. Oster Achia, throw it to Cyrus. Almost got it intercepted. Cyrus will kick it out. There's Mo Buckets for three. Got it! Mo Buckets for three, and the Cougars back to the lead. Under 3 minutes to go. Sykes is a one-man show here. Now they finally go to Cooper. Cooper, tough shot. Ball tipped, but it goes out, and the Cougars steal it. Troy Cole Jr., and a steal by Sykes. Cougars didn't need to push it that badly, but with 2:30 to go in the game, Greyhounds with the ball. 2:22 left to go in overtime. Cougars lead by one on the three by Mo Buckets. 10 seconds left to go on the shot clock. Nice flop there, but no call. Rebound by Boster Achia. 2 minutes to go in the ballgame. The Cougars by one. They're going to call three with a foul. That means Omar going back to the line. Robinson picks up the foul, his third. 1:52 to go in the overtime. The Cougars lead by one, 71-70. In following the game, we will have an interview with head coach Luke Norman, and we'll certainly bring the live announcement of the all-tournament team and MVP. My pick is at the line right now. Omar Njai, free throw, no good. Cougars struggling down the stretch from the charity stripe. Omar Njai, a chance to give the Cougars a 2-point lead here. Second free throw is short. Cyrus Noel, I thought, was going to come down with it. He didn't. Cougars still with a 1-point lead. They can't buy a free throw down the stretch. Sykes got away with a walk. Get it to Robinson, now down to Carpenter. Carpenter to Robinson. Four long three, and he got it. Wow, big three by Robinson. And gives a two-point lead to the Greyhounds with 1:18 to go. Oh, Buckets get the ball. 1 minute to go. Cyrus Noel. Trying to get it to him. And they're going to call a foul on Carpenter. That's his fourth. Going back to the line once again is Omar Ninjai. Two free throws coming, a chance to tie it up. 58 seconds to go in the ball game. Cougars need them now. First one up and in. 18 points for Omar Ninjai. 10 rebounds. One more free throw to go. Second free throw, up and in, tie ball game. Ninjai, 19 points now, 56 seconds left to go. If I'm the Greyhounds, I take a quick shot, and they're gonna foul out Ninjai. Jai fouls out with 19 points and 10 boards. Tyler Johnson checks in for him. The crowd gives him a big hand as he's had a great game. That could be your MVP. The Cougars are going to have to finish him off here in the last minute. 49 seconds left to go. Sykes back to the free throw line. First free throw, rounding out. Seconds left to go. On the miss here. It's going to be in. Sykes hits it. The Greyhounds with a one-point lead. There'll be 20 seconds left if the Cougars run it down to nothing. And a steal now. Oh, the Cougars had it back. And now the Cougars get the steal back. Troy Cole Jr., 30 seconds left to go. The Cougars can play for one shot. E2, and they're going to call it on Sykes. Sykes, what are you talking about? They've been calling trash all night. I love it when a player fouls him and then can't believe when he does. Two free throws for D2. Cougars down by one, 19 seconds to go. They need at least one. He's gonna shoot two. Both of them would be great. First free throw, up and in. Tie ball game, 12 points now for D2. One free throw to go. Tied at 74. My guess is it's gonna be Sykes for a runner. Maybe a Robinson three-pointer. Second free throw, up and in. Cougars by one. And yet another missed call, but timeout taken by Moberly. 19 seconds to go. Cougars with a lead, 75-74. We'll be back in a minute. Stick with us, everyone. The only place you can watch your Cougar game is right here.
This guy sucks.
Boo, you stink!
I can't see anything. Use your open eye, Frank.
I can't believe you're a professional. I think you should be working at the snack bar.
No timeouts left for the Greyhounds. Cougars still have their two. 75-74 Highland. 19 seconds left to go. The Greyhounds have been getting a foul called every time on a Sykes drive. I expect it to be the same. It's time for the Cougars to take a charge. They've been calling offensive fouls like they're going out of style tonight. Let's see if a Cougar can step up and draw it. Sykes again with the layup, just like I figured. 1 point lead for the Greyhounds, 10 seconds left to go. Take it to the hole! 7 seconds, he's going! No call, come on, there you go! Tee him up! Tee him up! Come on! Tee him up! Have the guts to call it! D2 needs two to win the game. Back to the line for two for D2. Fouling out is Carpenter.
Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road,
Gonzalo Bastarachia back in for the Cougars as Mo Buckets has a seat. D2, two free throws. He needs only one to keep the game going. Two would be great. And he got it. First one up and in for D2. D2 family came in from St. Paul, Minnesota, and they are getting a treat tonight. This one for the win. 76-76, 4 seconds left to go. Free throw, no good. Ball tipped out of bounds. That's Cougar. No, that's Cougar ball. They missed that one, but 4 seconds left to go. That is blue ball. That's blue ball. You can't have the ball go out of bounds off a Greyhound and give it back to him. That is blue ball. Time to make this one up. Blue ball, buddy. We got it. Blue ball, make the call. Of course. Full court pressure by the Cougars, trying to slow them down. Looks like we're going to double overtime. Tough shot for the win, no good, and we're going to another overtime. One's not enough. We're going to have to settle it again here. At the end of two overtimes, it's 76-76. The Cougars going to have to do it again. We'll be back in a minute. Third overtime coming here for your Highland Cougars. You want to watch it? The only place you can is here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone.
This guy sucks.
You stink!
Overtime number two. Well, who knows, it might go to three. Cougars struggling down the stretch with free throws, and we're still playing another one. Let's see if we can get a few calls this way now. 5 minutes to go, yet again, tied at 76.
It's tied at 68.
Regulators, mount up. We're coming.
For a third time now, Cyrus is going to jump center court. And the ball will be tipped and go to the Greyhounds. Sykes will kick out for once. Normally, he's taking it up. There's the charge! And it took him a long time to finally call one. D2 will take it. We finally get one.
Everybody clap your hands.
That's the fourth one on Reynolds. Three players have fouled out for the Greyhounds, one for the Cougars. D2 was running the risk of being the second one out, but he took the charge. .441 left to go in the 55th annual championship ball game for the Cougars. They led by as many as 15 in the second half, but some horrendous calls down the stretch got the Greyhounds back into it, and now we're in a second overtime. Tyler Johnson will hand off to Troy Cole Jr. Bo Buckets, now to Tyler. Up top, Troy Cole should just take it to the hole. Pull up jumper, no good. Still tied at 76. Sykes thought was gonna step back for three. Got it to Reynolds. Too many steps, but they're gonna give him the call. Or excuse me, that's Moye. Mo Buckets picks up the foul, his first. Let's see if Moye can hit some free throws here. May hit the first one. .357 left in this second overtime. 77-76, Moberly. And if anything, the Greyhounds have hit their free throws down the stretch. The Cougars wouldn't be in this game. They'd be hoisting the trophy if they'd hit theirs down the stretch. They hit just enough to stay alive, but they've missed several free throws. Ball goes out of bounds. Now it's blue ball. Yes, sir. Cougars might have got a gift there, but
I'll allow it.
3:41 left to go. The people working the sweat on the floor getting a workout here tonight. D2 will take the ball out for the Cougars. We'll get it up to Cyrus. D2 will go get it. Play D2, got caught up in the middle of the air, tried to drop it off to Cyrus. Greyhounds lead by two. It's their biggest lead of the ball game. Sykes got away with a walk, got it to Robinson. And Cyrus gonna get called for a foul. Foul on Cyrus, that's his third. D2 limping off as Boster Achia will come in for him. Again, I'm not sure if it's a cramping issue or not. First free throw for Robinson. 75% free throw shooter, and he missed it. In the biggest lead the Greyhounds have had all night is 2 points, and they're at it right now. Cougars led by as many as 15.
in the second half. Second free throw up and in. So the biggest lead now for the Greyhounds, 3 points, 79-76. 3:10 left to go in this second overtime. Troy Cole all the way to the rack. That's offensive goaltending. Score it. And the foul. Troy Cole Jr. having himself a night. That's number. That's 20 points now for Troy Cole Jr. Chance to tie the ball game up once again with 3:02 left to go in the ball game. Troy Cole Jr. 20 points. Make it 21. High ball game at 79. The Cougars keep answering. Sykes once again. Now Maye. Tough shot. Nope, and he did make it. Wow, I didn't think it would bounce in. 2-point lead for the Greyhounds. Troy Cole setting it up. 10 seconds to go in the shot clock. Over to Buster Chia. He's going to go all the way to the rack. Where's the foul? Buster Chia scores a bucket. It had gotten a foul on the other end. Tied again at 81 with 2 minutes to go in the ballgame. And Buster Chia will foul out. Cougars don't have that many guards left. D2 is injured. I don't know if coach is going to put in Ramin or not. And here he goes. All-American Ramin Hinton injured, but here he comes. Again, they didn't want to use him because to risk more injury. But a timeout taken by the Cougars. 2:02 left to go in the ballgame. In the second overtime, it's tied at 81. We'll be back in a minute. Stick with us here, everyone. The only place you can watch the end of this ballgame is right here. We are back for some more. I'm running out of voice here. Free throws coming for Sykes. Just over 2 minutes to go in the ball game. All-American Ramin Hinton got a bum ankle. He says he's feeling okay, but coach doesn't want to use him to risk possibly another injury for him. He's a big player for the Cougars. Sykes' first free throw up and in. Again, no question down the stretch, the Greyhounds have hit their free throws. The Cougars have not. Cougars have had a chance to take the lead in the end of this ball game and just come up short. And he missed it. Troy Cole Jr. picks up another board, his 10th of the ball game. Under 2 minutes, the Cougars down by one. Troy Cole all the way up. No call. That's a foul down there. Locked out of bounds, but the Cougars will maintain possession. Troy Cole Jr. will get it up. Tyler Johnson.
Troy Cole will take it himself now. Minute 45 left to go. Cougars down by one. Cole buckets. Ramin. Cole up for three. No good. Ramin, ice cold off the bench, though. Tough shot, but it wouldn't fall. 1:30 to go in the ball game. Cougars down by one. Boye loses the ball, and here come the Cougars. Troy Cole should take it to the rack. He does. Come on, call something. That's a guaranteed foul on the other end. Not on this end. Troy Cole Jr. picks up his fourth. More free throws for Sykes. He's been on fire from the line. We could use at least one miss here. He's missed a few, but he's been ice cold with ice in his veins down the stretch, and he nails another. 2-point lead for the Greyhounds. The Cougars have played too well in this game to let the poor officiating blow this one away. I take back the good first half by the officials, as their last one has been all over the place. Both sides not happy with their calls, and I understand why. 3-point lead with a minute to go. Cougars got to get a good shot. Troy Cole to Monum. Under a minute to go. Ramin with the ball. Cougars got to get some sort of a... Of course, nobody's going to call that. Timeout taken by Highland. We had the ball. Timeout taken by Highland. Nice job. 45 seconds left to go. D2 going to come in, I believe, probably for Ramin. But with 45 seconds left to go in the 55th annual William Bear Classic Tournament, the Cougars trail by 3, 84-81. Pat Smith working over the officials on the far end. He's got his call now here down the stretch. Seconds left to go, down by three. Coach is going to draw up something. Hopefully the Cougars can put one in the hole. They played too hard and too well in this game for it to get away now. Injury bug and foul trouble have come back to kill the Cougars here. They lost Njai, I believe, in the first overtime. We're almost through the second overtime. D2's gone down about four times, but like a warrior, he's back in. I don't know who's going to take the three. Maybe Mo Buckets. I don't know. Troy Cole Jr.'s had three. He's got 21 on the evening. How about a foul? There, Jesus. We've been getting fouled calls on the other end. We don't get any call down here.
This guy sucks.
You stink!
What about the foul? Call the foul. We'll shoot some more free throws. I guess we got to start flopping. Because that's what they get. 3 seconds left on the shot clock.
They're going to call a hold. There's a makeup call. Should have had the foul called a long time ago. Robinson picks up his fourth. Cyrus Noel to the line. The Cougars need them both. And they get the first one. Eleven points for Cyrus Noel and seven boards. Second free throw, got it! Cougars need a stop. I expect Sykes to probably wait and then take it himself. And a steal by Troy Cole! All the way in, called that foul! Holy cow! Troy Cole Jr. going back to the line! Troy Cole Jr. just might punch the MVP tonight. He's been the one that's hit the free throws down the stretch for the Cougars, and he's got two of them, a chance to give the Cougars the lead. Troy Cole Jr., sophomore from Baton Rouge. First free throw, missed it. It's all right, if he hits this one, it's still a tie game and we could go to a third overtime. Really rather not, I'd rather just win it now. 27 seconds left to go, Troy Cole Jr., a chance to tie the ball game up. Had a great steal off of Sykes. Second one, up and in. 22 points now for Troy Cole Jr. Tie ball game, one shot coming here, most likely for the Greyhounds. Crowd coming alive with a defense chant. And another attempt at the steal. Sykes is having problems. He'll fire it up on the other side. Tough shot coming, got it though. Timeout, taken by Highland. Tough shot by Reynolds, but he got it. And gives the Greyhounds a two-point lead, 84-86. I don't know who we're drawing it up for, but we need a three-point shot. We need to end this thing now. .3 seconds left to go. The Cougars are going to have to go the whole length of the court. Cougars are very good from the beyond the three-point arc. 46% for Bastra Chia. Unfortunately, he's fouled out. D2 at 47%. Tyler Johnson at 50%. Mona Mabood, Mo Buckets, 42% from beyond the arc. Find one of them three. And we got a chance. Question is, if you're the Greyhounds, do you foul? With the Cougars struggling from the free throw line. Let's see what Coach Norman has drawn up here. Again, the Cougars have played marvelously, led by 15 in the second half. Some very poor officiating all the way around allow the Greyhounds to get back in this game, and now they have a two-point lead. Cyrus Noel wide open down here. Nobody gonna go back and get him. Now they will. And get the ball to D2 with 3 seconds. Call a foul! You guys suck! You guys are terrible! Of course, no call as D2 got mugged. And the Greyhounds will finish off this game 86-84. We'll be back with the final scores and stats here and the head coach of the Highland Cougars, Luke Norman. They had the opportunity, and guess who screwed them over? We'll be back in a minute.
This guy sucks.
Boo! You stink!
We are back here. All tournament teams set to be announced here in a minute. D2, 14 points, 2 boards. Troy Cole Jr., 22 points, 10 boards. Omar and Njai, 19 points, 10 boards. Those are my three Cougars of the game. A great job by the Cougars. They fall to 8-5. They played well, but down the stretch, they ran out of gas. The Greyhounds were brutal shooting early on, and the Cougars needed to keep scoring. They did for the most part, but fall in the end. We're still waiting on the all-tournament team here. And we'll have the head coach of the Highland Cougars, Mr. Luke Norman, afterwards here in a minute. Eastern Iowa. Troy Cole Jr. will pick up an all-tournament bid. Omar and Njai also picking up a well-deserved one. Great job, guys. Cooper, I thought we'd get the MVP, but it's probably going to go to Sykes. With Sykes' game tonight, he had a great job. Yep. That's your all-tournament team, and Jai Troy Cole Jr. with the all-tournament team. Sykes had a game for the Greyhounds tonight. He's the reason they won it. We will be back in a minute with the head coach of the Highland Cougars, Mr. Luke Norman. Stick with us, everyone.
This guy sucks.
back here in a minute with head coach Luke Norman. So stick with us, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. We are here now with the head coach of the Highland Cougars, Mr. Luke Norman.
Coach, it was a tough game, but imagine what we can do when we're healthy. The injury bug hit us pretty hard tonight, but I was very proud as a fan. How the kids just came together as warriors and just fought through.
That's what I told them. I'm super proud of them. I mean, we had three guys who played over 40 minutes. Guys, D2 is cramping up. We couldn't find any guys off the bench at the end of the game because that was out. But what an effort by our guys. What a game. I mean, that's just a heck of a game. High-level JUCO game. Proud of them. And I think we get healthy, we get back. I think we're as good as anybody. We can beat anybody. And I think we proved that tonight.
Absolutely. With about a month to go with the break here, what can you tell guys? Keep the spirits up. Not let them get too out of shape.
I told them, go home, enjoy time with family, get refocused, re-energized, and also try to get in the gym a little bit if they can. Get conditioning and maybe shoot a few free throws.
Great game tonight, Coach. Wish we would have turned a little differently, but we're still proud.
Very fun game, man. We appreciate your guys' coverage as always.
Good luck to you. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Head Coach Luke Norman. The Cougars fall to 8-5 on the season. Had a great game here. Great tournament. But we will close it out there. Again, the Cougars fall 86-84 in double overtime to the 16th team in the nation, the Moberly Greyhounds. For the Salt and the Sound,
Arthur, King of the Briton.
This is the Marvelous One, Marvelous Mark Masters, saying goodnight. The next broadcast will be sometime in January, I believe. Where was it? January 11th. Is it the men or the women? I think it's the men. The men against Truman, but the way they showed up or didn't show up in this tournament, they might not be here. So we'll be back, hopefully, against Truman, get a little revenge for them missing this tournament out here. But anyways, for the Salt and the Sound, Arthur, King of the Britons, and the Marvelous One, Mark Masters, we will see you in the new year. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year to you all. Good night, everyone.